Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Storing in the sweet and massive name of Almighty Allah, who is the most gracious and compassionate. Gentlemen, it's really nice to meet you once again to my new timeline videos. You know, today I prepare a topic of noun. It means noun, roots of noun, and some more basic grammatical terminologies. So gentlemen, let's have a look. First, we have got a noun. What is noun? The word noun is taken from a Latin word, nomen, which means name. It means nomen is a Latin word and noun is an English word. So therefore we say that both of them means name. So let's come on the second, we say definition. Every naming word is called noun. Or noun is the name of person, place, thing, idea, and everything exists everywhere, that is called noun. Or basically we have got a definition. Noun is the name of person, place, thing, animal, quality, quantity, title, action, and idea. So you know, the first one we have got person. In person we say Ali, Asad, Mahmoud, etc. Let's come on place. School, Masjid, Pakistan, etc. Let's come to thing. Chair, pen, pencil, book, etc. Animal, cow, zebra, monkey, etc. Let's come quantity and quality. Quality we have got beautiful, we soft, hard, harsh, etc. And quantity, kilo, pound, dozen, etc. Title, engineer, doctor, professor, etc. In action we have got teaching, playing, singing, etc. In idea we have to say goodness and balance. So this is the definition and the basic term of noun. Let's come to roots of noun. According to roots of noun, we have got four categories, I mean classifications. Types of noun, cases or uses of noun, genders of noun, and numbers of noun. So let's have a look on types of noun. In English language, we have got seven types of noun. Then the first one here, we have got proper noun, common noun, compound noun, collective noun, material noun, abstract noun, and concrete noun. Number one, proper noun. Proper noun are those nouns which refer to proper person, place, and thing. Clear? For example, we have got proper person, Ali, Ahmad, Matiullah. Proper place, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Common Institute, etc. And proper thing, we have got dollar proper, piano man, iPhone mobile, these are proper things. Remember the noun, that proper nouns always start with capital letters or uppercase letters. Let's come on, common nouns are those nouns which refer to common person, place, and thing. Example is already given. In common, we say boy, girl, student, teacher, etc. What about common place? School, college, bus stop, etc. And common thing, marker, mobile, pen, etc. But remember that common nouns, they usually, the first letter of them are usually in small forms, except at the beginning of the sentence. It means if common nouns are used at the beginning of the sentence, the first letter of the common nouns should be capitalized. Example is already given here. That boys are intelligent than girls. Nobody in boys is capitalized because it is used at the beginning of the sentence. And girls, that is used at the end of the sentence. So the first letter of girl, G is in lowercase letter, I mean a small letter. So therefore we have got, so now we have got compound nouns, or those nouns which are composed of two or three words. For example, bus stop, college student, brother-in-law, etc. So what about formation of, you know, composition of compound nouns? Formation and composition of compound nouns, they are in four different grammatical terminologies or grammatical structures. I mean in grammar words. Components are formed of four different grammar terminologies. Number one, noun plus noun. You know, in noun plus noun, component is made of two simple nouns in which the first noun functions as an adjective, so it should be singular and form. For example, bus driver. Here, bus functions as an adjective and it modifies the noun driver. So the first noun functions as an adjective, so it should be singular and form. We cannot say buses driver. Or, so compound noun. The second formation, that is gerund plus noun. Gerund functions as a verbal noun. Clear? Here, component is composed of verbal noun, I mean gerund, a simple noun. Clear? Example is given, cooking school. So cooking is gerund and school is noun. So the combination of verbal noun plus simple noun is called the first formation. The second formation. Noun plus gerund. When a compound noun is made of a gerund and a simple noun, that is called the third composition or third step. For example, we have got bird watching. Bird is a simple noun and watching is a gerund. So that is. And the fourth one is, that is noun plus preposition plus noun. Here the composition is from three words. Do you know noun, preposition, and noun? Do you know, for example, sister player. So this was the definition, and this was the topic about them. Gentlemen,